So, hi. So, hi again. My name is Kat, and I am 31 years young. I just love people say that. And I have a lot I want to say, but then nothing at all, but then everything in the world, but then nothing at all. So I believe that I'm going to start by saying hello. Welcome to my channel. And I take a lot of pauses just to think, and I don't really like to cut, so this should just be one take, and I hope you enjoy. And it most likely won't be necessarily happy or very uplifting, or it's just saying how I feel currently, updating myself on my life as it stands. And a lot has been happening. A lot is always happening in my life, and I am ready to pause and step back and reflect and comprehend and understand. And it's okay. So, backstory. Recently, February 15th of this year, my baby sister, Aya, passed away. And I've not been doing well, you could say. Not been doing well at all, actually. And I do not talk about her to anyone. People talk about her to me, and I get triggered, and then I want to isolate and run away, but I cannot, because everyone grieves differently, and my grieving method is to run away and hide somewhere and just cry to myself and hope no one sees me, or try to talk to my two friends. Used to be three, but it's two now. And just try to not feel, but I feel a lot all the time in the most intense ways, and I always want to cry for everything. I see a duck swimming in the pond and I think it's so cute, I want to cry, so then I do. And I was coming out more from my shadows, from my darkness, around August. I started to find myself, and I started to eat again. And I was hospitalized, and I tried harder. And I tried to keep going, and I tried to look for comfort and safety and security in the people that I've known just as long and longer than she was alive. And one person in particular took advantage of that state of mind. And at times, this person would bring me up, but then other times, every other time, this person brought me down, made me hate myself more than I already do. And I'm not saying any of this to attack anyone. I'm just saying how I've been feeling. And this person took the most advantage of everything I was feeling for them. Everything I was feeling about myself and everyone else took advantage. And then made me out to be the person that I actively strive very hard not to be. I'm lost and sad and confused all the time, and I never want to be around people. Not necessarily because people just are terrifying, because they are. Just humans themselves are just terrifying. But it's the sounds of the world. I'm always hyper aware, and it's just the sounds of the world and the background noises, everyone talking. It's always been very overwhelming. So I just to drown out everything, play music so I can focus. Or try to just have my headphones in, really try to drown out the world. So okay. trying very hard to be strong and brave and super just happy, because right now as it stands I couldn't wish for anything more than what I have and the people I have. And I hardcore tried to hold firmly onto someone who didn't want to be held on to. So instead of losing one love of my life, I lost two. And in the span of 10 months, I lost two. This is the 16th. And on the 15th yesterday, 10 months after I lost one love, I lost another. One was stolen, but one I guess I really never had. Again, I'm not saying this to attack, just I'm feeling a lot. And I have to express I am feeling quite hurt from losing so much. I've gained so much more than I had before, but I've lost so much as well. So much. Got a divorce this year. And that's not even the person that I'm talking about. It's somebody completely different. One person was stolen. Person left. one person was never there, and all I have to willingly surrender. That's a lot to have to do in such a short time. That's a lot. I'm hurt. I'm so much pain all the time. And I don't want to be in pain anymore. I don't want to. I don't want to feel like I'm always crying. Feeling like I always have to cry. I love to smile. I love to be happy. But it doesn't seem like the universe wants me to be happy. And I don't understand why. Soul to everyone, everything, and I'm tired. I'm so tired. I give all of me to everything. I give all of me to people who don't deserve it. I do this because I want to be loved. Not as in my best friend loves me or my mom loves me. Or I want you to be a part of my relationship with my husband. I want to be loved by an individual, by someone who only loves me and no one else. I don't want to be shared. I know how selfish that sounds, but I want to feel wanted. I want to feel appreciated. I want to be cared for. By a person who cares about me in the exact same way, if not greater, than I could ever imagine. I always care greater. I always care more. I care more for everyone than I do about myself. And I guess that's where I kind of mess up, huh? I'd like to heal. I'd like to fix myself. I'd like to feel better about myself. Mentally and emotionally and physically and all the things. I'd like to get control of my life and my habits and my emotions and the will or the want to eat again. I haven't wanted to for so long. Eating got so bad without me realizing it. It's been so bad. My body feels like I've been literally dying. No matter how hard I try, I can't sleep, I can't eat, I can't. I feel like I can't survive without other people around. And I don't want that. Especially because I'm used to just being by myself. And I'm used to going places by myself, going to a park and taking pictures, or going to the movies by myself, or the mall and walking around, or just the beach, just to listen to the ocean, just see, feel the waves. I'm used to doing everything on my own. And now I've been demanding people around me. Because I'm losing so much. I'm letting everything and everyone grow up around me as in by myself. And I'm losing so much more than what I've gained. Material things are one thing. And though they're great and they can bring some sort of comfort, it's not love. It's not appreciation. It's not. I can appreciate those things and everything I have right now, but they won't be able to appreciate me because they are things. Sure, they have their temperaments, like cameras and stuff. Sure, you have to take your time and learn and all the things about photography and art and science and all the things and humans and animals. But only two of those things can actually return the love that you give. Show you that you are even more remarkable and beautiful than you could ever feel. I feel that way about my humans. I have a handful, and I see my humans as perfect figures of imperfections. They do things and they say things that just make you smile and make you feel safe and appreciated. But then when they'd say something and you hold them so high in your heart, you think so highly of them, they disappoint and they run away, and eventually they come back. But what's the point of coming back if you're just going to keep threatening to run away or simply doing it? I'm not a runner. I never leave. I stay and I fight for who and what I believe in. And I fix everyone, everything. I put all of me into everyone and everything. In every situation. But most humans don't tend to they don't tend to do the same. I have a thing that I say all the time that tends to hurt certain people, that everyone always leaves. And yeah, everyone always leaves. But some people do come back. But everyone always leaves. Everyone needs time to themselves. Everyone needs privacy. And needs me to understand that there are times when they just need to be alone. I completely understand that there's times when I need to be alone as well. But instead, I try my hardest to not separate, because when I do, people get upset with them, and they do. I'm not allowed to be upset. I have to let it happen, and I just don't think that's fair. I'm not sure what I've been saying so far, but I'm feeling a tiny bit better than what I was feeling 20 minutes ago. It started raining while I was talking, and then it stopped. It always rains when I feel really sad or really happy. Today has been raining on and off. I guess I don't really know what I'm feeling. I want to be happy, but I can't say that I am. But I really want to be happy. I want my art to fill me with joy again. Photography and nature and just plain art, like the sun's in the background. I didn't do that one. One of my best friends did that one, but the other one I did. I want to focus on me for a little while. And the year is almost over. There are two weeks left. So I will try to fix myself. I'm a little robot trying to understand human emotions. I'm constantly reminded that I am human myself. I am tired of hospital trips. I've been to 3 since September. No. June, July, September. No. July. 3 hospital trips since July. 1 recently. And the 1 very soon before that. They've all been for the same thing. A starving body and a broken soul. And I want to fix it. I want to fix myself. I want to put the pieces back together. I saw a picture online and I thought it described me so well, so I started drawing it. Let me get it. Hello again. So I found something like this. Well, it's not exactly the way it was in the picture, but I'm trying to do just this, trying to fix myself. Trying to put the broken pieces back together. Trying real hard. It's not even finished. Every time I try to fix, I get more broken. And I don't want to be broken anymore. Be so sad anymore. I want to be myself again. I want to figure out who I am, what myself is. I don't want to be a broken robot. I'm not sure how long this is, and I appreciate it if you stayed to the end. And instead of making this a part of other things, I will make this one video and I will say goodbye for now. I'll see you later. We never say goodbye, we say see you later. You say take care. You say have the most spectacular day. And may you find lilies growing on the side of the street. All the best of luck and the beauty in the world. Boy, I'm so dramatic. I love my drama. Okay. I will try my best to make this a weekly occurrence. Try to be more dedicated. It won't always be this type of sit down. Talk and stuff. It will be a lot of the time just to say how I feel about things, say where I'm at mentally and physically. And maybe we'll get into physically later. Today we're focusing on emotionally and mentally. And I guess if you want to give an overview of everything so far, physically I'm not doing so hot. Everything's broken. Everything's out of whack and everything's just. But I'm trying very hard, and one day I'll be able to eat Jell-O again. And I'll keep trying. So until next week, I hope you have an amazing day and an amazing week. Safe. Keep yourself protected. Keep your heart, your mind, your soul, your body. Keep you protected. Keep you safe. You are wanted and you are loved. You are appreciated in every way. Talking to myself, but also talking to everyone else. Okay. I've been Kat. Sorry for the sadness, and hope to see you again soon. What are the YouTube things to comment and like and share and all the things? You don't have to do that. I just appreciate you just being here for just a moment with me. Alright, I'm talking too long. Okay. Lit. As the kids say. Stopped raining. Just for a moment, it stopped raining. Alright. See you later.